I am Dr. W.B. Gurmuri from Kamalani Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today we are going to discuss the part number 6, and in this part we are going to discuss different types of oxide and particularly the preparation properties and uses of ozone, that is isotopes of oxygen, and also we are going to discuss the preparation properties and the application of sulfur dioxide SO2 compound. So these some important compounds of this block element we are going to discuss in today's presentation. So the today's topic is the element of group number 16, 17 and 18, chapter number 7 and the part 6. So today we are discussing simple oxides. As we know that oxides are the binary compound of the oxygen with the element, and this new compound formed is the oxides. And oxide are four types. One is acidic, basic, amphoteric and neutral oxides. So oxide are all the four types. Acidic, it may be in acidic nature, basic and also amphoteric and also neutral. So what do you mean by the acidic oxide? So in this case we can say that as oxides may be acidic. So such type of oxide when dissolved in the water give the acid. This is the one, as we know that the material when they are dissolved in the water forming the acid, so such type of oxides are known as acidic oxide. Or in other words, also we can say that it reacts with the base to give the salt. That is general reaction, acid plus base forming the salt and the solvent. So in this way also, if it is acid, then it reacts with the base forming the salt. So this is known as the acidic oxides. So either that compound dissolved in water or it reacts with the base forming the compound, depending upon that it is acidic in nature. Examples are given here. Number of examples are here: SO2, SO3, CO2, N2O5, Cl2O7 are the example of acidic oxide. Some reactions are given here that SO2 when react with the water forming this type of compound H2SO3, and this SO3 SO2 react with the NaOH forming Na2SO4 and water. So this type of reaction can take place. So here what is this SO3 is a acid and this is base forming this salt. Here it dissolves in water forming this type of compound. So both these oxides are acidic oxides, and oxide of nonmetals are generally oxides, acidic oxide. And in the next slide here, what are the basic oxide, amphoteric oxide and neutral oxide. So basic oxide are those oxide when dissolved in water give the base, or it react with the acid forming the salt. So opposite to the acidic oxide, here basic oxide are those when it dissolves in water forming the base, or it when it react with the, if it is a base, basic in nature, then it react with the acid forming the salt, which is known as basic oxides. Some examples are here, sodium oxide, calcium oxide, barium oxide, like this. And here this calcium oxide dissolves in water forming calcium hydroxides. Barium oxide react with the acid, this is a base forming salt, barium chloride, and the solvent. So some oxides are basic in nature, and some more oxides are there. Third number, that is amphoteric. Amphoteric means the oxide which act as a both acid as well as base. So as we know that amphoteric solvent, amphoteric compound. So these are the oxides which are in amphoteric in nature. When these oxides act as both, that is act as acid as well as base. And amphoteric oxide examples are aluminium oxide, Al2O3. Aluminium oxide reacts with the base when it is acid here and forming this type of compound, complex type of compound. So here sodium hexaico aluminium, and so here aluminium oxide is acidic in nature. Here aluminium oxide is a basic in nature. So it reacts with the if it is a base, then it reacts with the acid forming this type of compound. So aluminium oxide are amphoteric oxide because this aluminium oxide shows both react with the acid and also react with the base. So both acidic and basic in nature. Now this is the compound or oxide which act as acidic as well as basic. Therefore it is known as amphoteric oxide. One more is there, neutral, not acid, not basic. So the oxide which are neither acidic or not basic are known as the neutral oxide. Examples are here carbonyl CO, nitrosyl NO and N2O, nitrogen oxide. So these are some examples of neutral oxides. So oxides may be four types: acidic, basic, amphotericic and neutral oxides. And now one more important compound is there, that is the preparation of ozone. And in case of preparation of ozone, ozone have the formula O3. It is the allotropic forms of the oxygen. And here preparation of ozone method is there. And ozone can be prepared by in the laboratory by passing electric discharge and through the pure and dry oxygen in an apparatus which is known as ozonizer. And the conversion of oxygen to ozone is only 10%. The product is known as ozonized oxygen. And it is a endothermic reaction process. See here, this much amount of energy is required, energy is absorbed, and oxygen is converted to the ozone. So here, oxygen is converted to ozone by absorbing this much amount of energy. So this is endothermic process, and oxygen is converted to ozone. So this is the preparation of ozone. Simple method is there, and the reaction is carried out in the apparatus which is known as ozonizer. And some important physical properties are there. These are not so important, but we should know. Pure ozone is a pale blue gas, dark blue liquid, violet black solid. Different nature is there. Ozone has characteristic smell. When inhaled in concentration above 100 ppm, it causes nausea and headache. And it is also diamagnetic in nature. And one more here, that for numerical problem number 7.9, that high concentration of ozone can be dangerously explosive. So if the concentration of ozone is high, then it is act as a very dangerous and explosive. So why? It is because thermal stability of ozone is that is, we can say that ozone is thermodynamically unstable, and as compared to the oxygen, and therefore it decomposes into oxygen. Decomposition is an exothermic process and result in the liberation of large amount of heat, and therefore it increases the entropy, and this result in the result in large negative Gibbs energy change. And that is why concentration of high concentration of ozone can be dangerously explosive. So this is the reaction that ozone forming this nascent oxygen and oxygen. So this is the decomposition. Because it is unstable, and decomposition is take place, and forming ozone is converted into oxygen and nascent oxygen. That is why it is very explosive, dangerous compound. And some chemical properties are there of this ozone, and different chemical properties have been shown here. That in case of chemical properties, first is the oxidizing property. Ozone is also a powerful oxidizing agent, and it decomposes nascent oxygen here. Decomposes and forming nascent oxygen. So here this is the ozone forming oxygen and nascent oxygen. Therefore it is a powerful oxidizing agent. And ozone oxidizes lead sulfide to lead sulfate. So here iodide ion into iodine. So here lead sulfide ozone react with this and forming lead sulfate and oxygen gas is evolved. And in case of potassium iodide, it react with the ozone in presence of water, forming potassium hydroxide, iodine is formed. So it iodide ion is reduced here, oxidizes to iodine, and lead sulfide oxidizes to lead sulfate. So these are the some oxidizing property of this compound. And ozone also oxidizes nitrogen oxide and forming nitrogen dioxide. So here this is nitric oxide or nitrogen oxide. When react with the ozone, forming nitrogen dioxide compound. And therefore nitrogen oxide is the exhaust system. Supersonic jet aeroplane can bring forth depletion of ozone. Because of this NO2, there is a depletion of ozone layer in the upper atmosphere layer is taking place. So this is dangerous. And another reaction of this in case of chemical properties of ozone is the bleaching property. It is an important property that ozone act as a good bleaching agent, and it shows the reaction again. Now here ozone forming nascent oxygen and oxygen, and here this any colored matter is there, then it nascent oxygen react with this and forming colorless matter. Ozone bleaches in absence of moisture, so it is also known as a dry bleach. So this is so it act as oxidizing, showing oxidizing property, also act as a bleaching agent, and also ozone is also act as a reducing, showing a reducing property. Ozone reduces peroxide into oxide. So here hydrogen peroxide react with oxygen forming this here forming this type of oxide H2O and oxygen. Barium peroxide react with this ozone forming barium oxide, and so they form peroxide is converted into oxide by reducing. So ozone can be used as a reducing reducing the compound. And another fourth important property, that is as we know that the ozone depletion, and in case of ozone depletion that is the thinning, or also we can say that decrease the concentration of ozone in the upper layer of the atmosphere. So this is known as decreasing concentration of ozone in the layer, which is known as ozone layer depletion. And because of that, here how depletion is taking place. So ozone O3 layer in the upper atmosphere absorb harmful UV light coming from the sun, and after absorbing this, so because of that it protecting us or people on the earth. So sometimes there is a ozone hole, and if there is a ozone hole, what is the UV rays come directly to the earth, and it also causes number of skin problems and other. So here, so because of this ozone layer, it protect us from the harmful UV radiation. Another depletion of ozone layer in the upper atmosphere causes because of this is nitrogen oxide that is exhaust from the car or supersonic jet aeroplane. So reaction is shown here, that is nitric oxide coming from this exhaust of the car, and what is react with ozone and forming NO2. So NO2 deplete the ozone layer. So depletion, also known as thinning of this ozone layer, can also be caused by the chlorofluorocarbon, as we know that freon, that freon generally used in the aerosol and the refrigerators, air conditioner. So this freon, also known as chlorofluorocarbon, can be reduces the concentration of ozone. It reacts with the ozone and reduces the concentration, or we can say that depletion of this ozone layer can take place because of this freon. And another point is that the depletion of ozone layer can also be taking place in the polar region, especially the over Antarctica. And another point is that ozone depletion is a major environmental problem, as it increases the amount of UV radiation that reaches the earth's surface and causing the increase in the rate of skin cancer, eye contact, and genetic as well as the immune system damage among the people. So these are some important points about the ozone depletion. And here ozone reacts with the unsaturated compound containing the double bond to form addition product. This is known as ozonide. Ozonide are decomposed by water or dilute acid and give the aldehyde or ketone. This reaction is also known as ozonolysis. So ozonolysis is the reaction. And here this is one important point. Do you know that here ozone react with the unsaturated compound containing the double bond, that is unsaturated compound, forming the addition product which is known as ozonide, and the reaction is known as ozonolysis. So this is important reaction also taking place, ozonolysis. Now in case of structure of ozone, as we know the formula, molecular formula is O3, and here this is the structure shown, O, double bond O, and single bond O. So this is the canonical structures, and now double bond position is changed, and these structures are similar. As we know, oxygen have atom number 8 and 6 electrons are there. Out of 6 electrons, electrons are shown. Out of these 6 of the oxygen, 4 are here, 2 electrons are taking part in this bond formation. Here 6 electrons are as it is, and this is the bond. Here are the 2 electrons, 2 are here, 2 are here. So in this way the structures of ozone is there, and combine of these 2, this is the complete structure, and this bond angle O bond angle is 117 degree. Here this bond length of double bond is a 128 and both are the similar. So uses of ozone. So this is the structure, and structure is a, we can say that this is the bent structure, or also known as the angular structure. And now what are the uses of this ozone? Ozone is used for air purification at crowded places like cinema hall, tunnels or railways. And another application of this ozone is in sterilizing the drinking water by oxidizing all germs and bacteria. So it is very important compound for bleaching every oil, starch, wax and delicate fabrics such as silk. So this is third important application of uses, and in the manufacture of synthetic camphor, potassium permanganate, for this also preparation. So these are the some important uses of the ozone. So ozones are very important compound. And now second important compound is the compound of sulfur. And in case of compound of sulfur, some preparation reactions are given here. So there are three methods of preparation of sulfur dioxide, important compound of the sulfur, and compound is a sulfur dioxide. Preparation, first method is from sulfur, and SO2 can be prepared directly when sulfur react with oxygen forming SO2. And it also be prepared from the sulfide when the sodium sulfide is with the sulfuric acid forming the sodium sulfate, and here SO2 is obtained. Another method is that from sulfide, this is the industrial method, and sulfur dioxide can be prepared by roasting zinc sulfide and iron pyrite. So this is the zinc blende or zinc sulfide react with oxygen when it is heated forming zinc oxide and SO2 gas is over. Or another, this is the sulfide of iron and react with oxygen forming. This is the ferrite and ferric oxide and SO2 is formed. So these are the three important methods of preparation of sulfur dioxide, compound of sulfur. These physical properties are not so important, but sulfur dioxide is a colorless gas with a pungent smell. It is poisonous in nature. SO2 is highly soluble in water, and solution of in water is called the sulfurous acid. And this SO2 is liquefied at the temperature under pressure and boils at 263 Kelvin. Physical properties are not so important, but chemical properties are important. And in case of the chemical properties, reaction with the chlorine, and here SO2 react with the chlorine forming, this is the compound sulfuryl chloride. So when SO2 react with the chlorine forming, this is the addition compound, and forming the in presence of charcoal forming sulfuryl chloride. And SO2 also react with the oxygen and forming vanadium, in presence of vanadium pentoxide forming sulfur trioxide. So this is the important reaction. SO2 is converted to SO3 in the presence of P2O5 by reaction with oxygen. Another reaction is the reaction with sodium hydroxide. So this sodium hydroxide react with the SO2 forming sulfite and water is released. So these are some important reaction. And next reaction is reaction with the sodium sulfide. So sodium sulfide react with the SO2 forming this type of sodium bisulfite. And in case of reducing property, sulfur dioxide acts as a reducing agent, and show here. So my sulfur dioxide reduces ferric salt into ferrous salt. So ferric is plus 3, ferrous is plus 2. So plus 3 SO2 react and forming Fe2+. So this is ferric and this is the ferrous. So this is for conversion. It acts as a reducing in nature, and sulfur dioxide is a reducing agent. And most moist sulfur dioxide decolorizes acidified potassium permanganate, where this permanganate magnesium have 7 oxidation state, and here KMnO4 SO2 react and forming this K2SO4 and MnSO4. So this is the reaction. And moist sulfur dioxide also reduces halogen to halogen acid. So this is the reaction. Iodine is converted into iodide. So this is the reaction where this iodine is converted into iodide. So moist sulfur dioxide reduces halogen into, this is the halogen iodine, reduces to the halogen acid, hydroiodic acid. And in case of structure of sulfur dioxide show this again, another two structures are there. Double bond is here, now double bond is here. Both the structures are canonical structures, identical structures. Only the position of bonds have been changed, and these are the two identical structures. And the structure is the bent structure, also known as the angular structure. And there are some important application of the sulfur dioxide compound. and these important applications are it is used in the refining of petroleum and also sugar. This compound is used in the bleaching wool and silk. This compound is also used as an anti-chlor and disinfectant. It also used as a preservative and also used for the manufacture of sulfuric acid and sodium bisulfite. This compound liquid SO2 is used as a solvent to dissolve number of organic and inorganic chemicals. So these are the some important uses of this sulfur dioxide compound. So we have discussed number of first of all, what are the types of oxide, and after that also the important compound, that is ozone, preparation properties and the uses, and here compound of sulfur dioxide. And in the next slide we are going to see the so here this is the important compound of the sulfur and forming this type of property. So here today we have discussed the simple oxides, the types of oxide, and important compound of ozones, ozone and sulfur dioxide, and all these part are important. And in this case that is the preparation, chemical properties and uses are very important from the examination point of view. So today we stop here, and remaining part we will discuss in the next video.